Hello, hello, and welcome to another Rangaroo's unit of the Reek. And today we're taking a look at the Ox and Bucks available to the 6th Airborne Division. The Ox and Bucks is nothing to do with actual farm animals, but is a shortened version of the full regimental name, the Oxfordshire and Buckinghamshire Light Infantry Regiment. Now, to skip a lot of regimental history and just get down to the meat and potatoes of it, the Ox and Bucks were the first guys to land in Normandy just after midnight, and they were the people holding down Pegasus Bridge till they got relieved by the landing forces. So essentially, if you've seen the movie The Longest Day and you remember the whole hold till relief scene, yes, it's those guys. In-game, the Ox and Bucks is available in A phase for the 6th Airborne Division, and they have 4 different weapons available to them. So the infantry's weapon selection consists of 2 Sten guns, 6 Leinfields, 2 Brens, and a Pier. So it's a very healthy mix of weaponry. You got an extra submachine gun for CQC combat, 2 Bren guns which give you much better firepower than just 1 Bren gun, as well as a Piat for some anti-tank capabilities. This is a very all-round infantry squad, where they're not the best at CQC or long-range firefight or anti-tank, but they can kind of do it all in one convenient package. Take a look at the Miscellaneous stats. They got a strength of 10, good stealth, a speed of 20 kilometers an hour, normal optics capability, and a heavy cargo space. In battle, the Ox and Bucks is a rather useful unit added in the recent free unit update. Essentially, they are just an AB Bren group with a Piat. That's all they have different compared to the AB Brens. But the Piat is a rather useful piece of kit. Even though it isn't accurate as hell, your other option for the majority of your infantry for 6th Airborne are gammon bombs. And gammon bombs are even worse than Piat. I doubt one of the worst anti-tank weapons in game. So having something that's sort of unreliable to something completely unreliable is much better. Also, compared to the Bren guns, you can only get Ox and Bucks in packs of 3s compared to packs of 4s. So it is a rather risky trade-off if you just want to get Ox and Bucks for the extra AT, but you don't have as many dudes overall. Yeah, as I said before, pretty all-round infantry squad. They're not the best at anything. Yes, the Bren gun is kind of crap, but you also got to realize the Bren gun can shoot while on the move, so they're rather good at attacking a position over a short to medium distance. They do have the 2-star veterancy, which helps out quite a bit when dealing with low-star German, Ostruppen, and Panzer Grenadiers. So, yeah, pretty good infantry unit all around. I think one of the major contributions to the 6th Airborne is it allows you to have a very heavily A-focused infantry setup, like you would with a commando deck, for example. It's very risky to go for that setup, because once you run out of infantry, that's it, and you don't have that much infantry, but the day you got a lot of 2-star guys to hold the front line. And yeah, they're pretty alright, and they will definitely hold until they are relieved. And I'm relieved off that. This has been another Rangaroo's unit of the Reek. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and as usual, please just take it easy.